Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about our paper on food insecurity at home and learning trajectories using Young Life data from India.
The concept of food insecurity refers to difficulties in consistently accessing enough safe and nutritious food to support a healthy life.
We wanted to answer two key questions. First, is there an association between household food insecurity in childhood and educational outcomes in early adolescence? And second, how do the timing and persistence of food insecurity in childhood matter for educational outcomes?
Food insecurity is a key societal challenge for India. One of out of four people in the world that are undernourished live in this country, and 40% of children under five are stunted or chronically malnourished.
To measure food insecurity, we used an experience-based scale in the Young Lives data. Across rounds, we documented whether the household was never food insecure, whether it transitioned into or out of food insecurity at specific periods, or whether it was always food insecure. Our key outcomes were children's test scores at age 12 in four domains: reading, vocabulary, maths, and English.
We have four main results. First of all, food insecurity impairs learning across the board, as you can see from this figure. Secondly, being food insecure at age 5 or being chronically food insecure are the most important predictors of worse learning attainments. Third, transitory food insecurity, which means entering in and out state of food insecurity at home, does not predict vocabulary scores at 12 years old. However, transitory food insecurity does matter for math scores. And this may be how the math curriculum may be structured, which may catching up more difficult from some periods of deprivations.
We do not claim any causality in this research, but we do provide rigorous findings on the relation between food insecurity and learning.
Complementing existing research, our research suggests to improve learning is critical to address food insecurity experienced by children at home and at school. We need to expand existing nutrition program to include breakfast for children at high risk of food insecurity or in the lean season. We also need to intervene early because some curriculum is cumulative. It may be difficult for children who experience childhood food insecurity to catch up on learning later. Moreover, we need to offer some remedial learning opportunities for groups such as tribal population who are at higher risk of food insecurity, and particularly for those skills for which catch-up is more challenging, for example, maths. So, teaching at the right level can help children who have fallen behind to catch up with peers.
Our work capitalized on the longitudinal nature of the Young Life data to highlight how both the timing and the persistence of food insecurity at home really matter for children's learning trajectories in their early adolescent years. Thank you so much for your attention, and if you need more detail, you can find the paper in this link.